Hey everybody, IGozLuigi here and welcome back to some awesome Pokemon World Online. Today we're going to be exploring Route 44. Now I'd like to point out that something that has occurred to me. None of my Pokemon are actually ready for the 8th gym in the Johto region. Hear me out, it's a Dragon type. Now you're probably wondering with the team I got, I should be able to put up a fair fight. But I'm just wondering that none of my Pokemon have any good moves against Dragon type Pokemon. And even my Gyarados, it doesn't know Ice Beam. So what I'm going to do before I actually face that gym in the next episode or whenever is go get Ice Beam, because having an Ice Beam with me would actually be much more beneficial for my part, because I don't want to lose the gym and then have to wait 24 hours just to reface it, because that's just a pain in the ass. So hopefully on Route 44 I can actually get a decent few levels, get some experience on my Pokemon, and then should be in a good shape of my life to actually kick that gym leader's arse in, because it's been a long time since we've done some ass whooping. The ice gym in the last episode was one of the most frustrating ones ever, because I've relied on my Arcanine throughout the entire episode, and I don't really like to rely on one Pokemon. I like to rely on my entire team, so I wasn't really confident going in there, but we still won, but we were really lucky. But this is a dragon type gym. It's the 8th gym and it's much more harder. So I'm just hoping that I'm actually am ready. So I'm hoping to get Pidgeot past level 70, get my team just roughly about the 70 marker. Then I should be fine to tackle any other Pokemon trainer that comes along my way. Because I can't really go to the battle tower just yet. So I might as well just prepare myself for the worst. And if I do beat this gym, then thank God to the heavens above, because it'd be a pain in the ass. So, let's hope one more level for my Pidgeot and then we're there. We are there. I can't remember what lies on Route 44, so it's all a mystery for me. But I remember it's not that big of a deal. So if I keep thinking like that, then it should all be fine. The only issue I have with these Pokemon trainers is because they're level 26 Pokemon, not very strong. Especially for that one. I'm hoping the next trainer will be a much more powerful Pokemon, because I'm looking for the 30 plus range, probably the 40 if lucky, because those are where the most XP is. And see, I'm not really getting a lot, but if it's evolved one, then I'm getting some. But with my double XP, it does actually add up. But it's going to take me a while before I actually am fully prepared. And I can't go to MT Silver yet until I got the 8th badge, so a lot's going on through my mind. I've got to think, well, I've got to be prepared for a lot of things, because they could announce Hoenn in the next couple of weeks, or they could announce anything on top of me. And I'm guessing Hoenn region is going to be much more prepared than this. It's going to have much more better trainers, much more harder, because considering that we don't have the option to start in Hoenn, so going over there we have to have a full decent team like we have to even face their trainers. So I could easily, once that is available, get up to level 100 on my team. And I'm just going against this rock type, and that's just the worst move ever. So I'm going to switch out to my Gyarados, because it's nearly leveled up to level 68. And hopefully I can teach it Ice Beam. If I can, my Gyarados will be my trump card in the dragon type gym, because I can get ranked up for the NPCs. But it's that dragon trainer that I've got to watch out for. I don't know why I didn't get Ice Beam before. I probably did, but I must have been an idiot and thought, oh, I won't probably need it. And now I do. I don't think Psychic works against it, so I'm not 100% sure. I'm not putting my faith in a move that I don't know that much about. And we have to go through a cave. Wow. I actually forgot about the cave. And can't talk to Cold Susan. I get quite cold in this cave. I ran a warm surface that can get you the other side pretty quick if you like. The charger's heating equipment and a surface itself. If you have 15,000 Poké Dollars and the self-raising badge. Well, it says self-raising badge, but I'm not paying this ridiculous price. So let's just go face the cool trailer Alan. I'd just rather go for the cave. If you want to waste money like that, go ahead. Look at me. I'm over 200k. I'm trying to get 250. And once I'm there, I can actually buy a bike. The first time, legitimately, I'm buying a bike without selling any of my Pokemon. That's how it's done. I haven't even got the bike on my main account. So seeing this here is pretty amazing itself. So I'm going to take on this one as well. A lot of people say that there's no big deal about the bike, and I'm thinking, yeah, there is. It's like an accomplishment. You've got the Wind Surfboard. Like, they knocked that down in price. It's only 50,000 now. I remember that used to be more than 50,000. I don't know the exact price, but I know it was definitely much more than 50,000. I think it was over 80 or 100k. And the bike was just like 500k or some bullshit like that. So I'm actually glad they halved down the prices on each of them, because it makes it much more easier for me to actually get there. So in total, you need about 300k, and I only wasted a bit of my money on resources I need, which I've still got plenty of those resources. So really, you can stretch yourself thin, just buy Pokeballs and hope for the best, or train your Pokemon from the ground up, which is much more better experience in my book. But lots of people have their different tactics. Lots of people like to pick Pokemon and then sell them if they got high Vs, if they're shinies. They train them, they work on them, and then they sell them for a much more higher price because you've done the work and not them. And if you're training MT Silver, then you're definitely going to get that Pokemon maxed out easily. And now it's level 100, it makes it much more beneficial to have a shiny at that level. Because I know once you get past like, the 80 marker, it gets much more difficult because you won't have like strong trainers to reface. Well, you can need to wait 2 weeks, but that's a really, really long time, and it can get really depressing sometimes when you're just waiting around to rebattle every trainer over and over again. So, good on the people finding the shinies. I got membership since I was like, okay, not the whole way through, but I know when I started I got a membership, and I still haven't found a shiny at all on this let's play. So you know how hard it is. Finding shinies is difficult. Some people have their own methods of breeding and stuff like that. So it really depends on what you enjoy the most. Do you want to breed to get your shiny, or do you just want to go out there like a badass and just capture them? That's my opinion. What I'm going to try and do, since these Pokemon are past level 30, I can get a lot of XP from them. So if I just keep battling here for a while I'm making my way there, I should be at a decent level to face a gym leader. But at the same time, I would still prefer to have Ice Beam on me. That is a main issue to be able to resolve, which I probably will do off screen, because I don't want you guys seeing me walk to a Pokemon Center to another Pokemon, then Pokemon Market to a market just to find the one that I need. Because I could be there for ages. It's like finding a needle in a haystack. You could be there for ages. Same with shinies as well. So, I don't think there are no trainers in here. I remember in the Crystal or the Silver and Gold cartridge games, there used to be trainers in this area, which were nice and the face and all that. But that's what I'm thinking, that there should have been trainers. So I'm guessing they're going to be on the next floor. If there aren't no trainers in here, that's going to be really disappointing. Because I was hoping there'd be some trainers. And my character's going backwards and forwards. I bet it's doing the thing and it's just out of control. If it does that, I'm screwed already. It's the one thing I hate about this place. Like, you gotta have the controls sorted, or it's not gonna happen for you. Okay, my controls are working. I have no idea what the hell was happening. I didn't even have my hand on the keys when they were moving left and right. Like, most of the time, I think my keyboard's possessed. It has a mind of its own, and happens a lot. Probably because I've got so many USB ports into my laptop already. I think it's trying to compensate for all of them, but then again, my laptop isn't the best laptop. But at least it plays my games, I've got no worries about it. Oh god, mazes, I really hate these mazes. It sucks so bad. I bet actual people who are like diehard Pokemon fans, like, are saying, oh god, you're screwing up and all that. And then here's me like, yeah, I don't give a shit. I know I'm bad. Okay, I've got it. That's the easiest one, apparently, people say, but you saw me screw up. And I'm taking, like, yeah, dead end. I'm not good at this, am I? Oh god. Oh god, how can I be so bad? Hang on, bear with me. Shit. Fuck. Shit, I'm stuck here now. Would you believe? Okay, I got it. Thank God, my mind was just like working out the puzzles. I used to be good at puzzle solving games when I used to play them on my computer, because back when I was growing up, we didn't really have like computer games as well. We were playing solitaire and like a little puzzle matching games and whatnot. People were saying, oh, those aren't really like considered competitive and puzzle games, but to me, at that age, when I was young, I'd consider it a challenge. Still do now. I like to give it a swirl once in a while. So let's go through here. This is the wrong way. It's going to be so painful because I had to backtrack, and my backtracking is like the worst. Like, I do worse going backwards more than I do forwards, and that is a fact. That is true. If you watch me play, you can see that I screw up, and most of the time, most of you are like, oh god, I just want to take the controls off this person and put him out of his misery because this is torture. Like, if there was such crime as, like, if you get arrested for, like, causing people mental damage because you can't play a game properly, I've been sized so many times getting fucked. It's unbelievable. Okay, I think I'm on the right path. I'm not 100% sure, but it looks like the right path. So we've got a Delibird here. Now, do I want to actually catch this Pokemon? Well, I'm going to try to do Dragon Rage. I got it down to half HP. I actually do want to catch this Pokemon just so I can have it on my team. I'm just hoping, can I get it? No, he broke free! You, how dare you! I gave you a ball and you give me a present! Shakes, do the Harlem Shake, and I caught the Delibird! Yeah! If I could actually name Pokemon in this, I'll call it Dilly Dildo. Just because that's what it reminds me of. When I always think of Dilly, I think, I'm one of Dildo. Alright, let's take this down. And... okay, I'm level 68, but I need to get level 70. Because I know that the gym leader is going to have Pokemon over level 70 and possibly level 80. Because I know it's going to have Dragonite. And I've had Dragonite. I'm just on my way to Blackthorn. Well then, I guess you shouldn't bother you any longer. You should be best getting... I was getting hot... Okay. Don is just Don, I suppose. I would fall down the holes, but I'm not going to risk it. I'm going to take the stairs. I don't think falling down the holes actually does anything. I think it's just there as like an option. But I'm just going to take the safe route. I'm going to take the stairs like a normal human being. And a level 37, you do, dude. I didn't probably need it. But if it was... that's the thing. Every time I start a Pokemon, I think, is that a good one on IV? Because that's really mad at the end of the day. And we're into another Pokemon battle. Oh, God. And this is due to do that level 33. Damn, the last one's much more stronger and good looking as well. But 10,000 XP, can't go wrong. Thank you. Goodbye. God, I should have really had like this all mapped out and planned, but I don't bother like doing that because I think I know the route, but then I remember I didn't play the game like it took, like I didn't play the game in like till like 6 years ago. So my memory is dry. Oh, and I'm, never mind, my memory is fresh! Yes, my memory is top notch. What the hell is that guy doing? Okay, Pokemon battle, why not? My memory is much more better than what I thought, and I'm in a Pokemon battle. And I'm curious about what that guy's doing facing a wall. If there's some sort of special Pokemon in there, I'll go in there and I will fuck it up. I will literally put my dick in that rear end. What? Oh, sorry. Wait! It's all been caved in. You can't go through here. Okay, so... alright, just do that then. I don't know what they're doing in there, but it can't be an event. If it is an event, fucking hell. Hope it's a fucking good one, I can tell you that one. Alright, Gita dude, let's see what you got. Just gonna take you out here. I could always run away from the battle, but I need the XP. I didn't really get a lot. I got my Pidgeot at level 71 now, so that's pretty good. Defense is pretty good. This is one of my best Pidgeots that I have. Like, the last one I had was all overall good, but the speed was 1. This one's 4, but it's better than having it as 1. But, you know, can't complain, can I? Let's go through here. I've got more puzzles! I hate puzzles. They annoy me. You know how bad I am at them. God. I'm hoping, yes, I got it right. I seriously hate puzzles in this game. Especially when, like, in some games they put trainers in here, but they didn't on this one, so they actually went easy on me for a change. It's quite nice that they actually do that in once in a while. It's not like pro, every time you, like, play, it gets more and more harder, like, oh, like, in the pro one, I don't know what universe they're in, but I love it. Alright, I'm here now. Thank God. There's the exit. Bombayage. I used to love that movie. Oh, I'm going to talk to this guy. Macadabra. No, I do not want to be taken there, you son of a bitch. See, he offers 500 just to teleport us over there, but then it costs 15,000 to get back. Well, you came through the icy path, but you can get a monorail here now, so all you gotta do is walk through it once, and instead of paying 15,000, if you don't want to walk through the cave, go get a monorail and then get delivered here for 5,000. So you're saving 10,000 Pogo dollars anyway. So here we are in Blackthorn City, but I'm not going to bother with this place at the moment. I'm just going to heal my Pokemon up. We will be exploring this place next time, but no, we probably, no, you know what, we got 15 minutes. I'm going to take 5 minutes just to, like, explore Blackthorn, because there's not quite a lot. We go down here and we got another route on the Route 45, which there is a cave. We'll probably explore that another time. Route 45, mountain road ahead. We got researcher Aiden. The Skarmory are running rampant, as we predicted. Collect 10 silver discs they seem to be carrying to help us determine why. So that's a quest. We got to collect 10 silver discs, which I probably will do that next time. All right. Blackthorn House. There's nothing in here. This place is like a ghost town. 50,000 people used to live here. Now it's a ghost town. Ooh, sky. Yep. 15,000. What the fuck? Why would you pay that price when someone's teleporting in the same area for 500? I don't really want to take the subway because I've got 2 transportation tickets at the moment. There's the gym. And through here is the Dragon Guard. Okay. And this, the den is only for serious dragon enthusiasms. You must get permission from a dragon expert in order to enter. Now, originally in the old Pokemon games, you had to beat the gym before you actually get permission to go in there. But in this one, you have to do the dragon's quest. We'll probably show that off next time or whatever, because we still got, like, get our Pokemon all ready. But we could face, probably get Ice Beam, face this gym, kick some serious butt and whatnot. Gym tips. I'm probably not going to be bothered with that one. But there's quite a few things that we can get done in the next episode before we actually face the gym, to be honest, because there's going to be quite a lot to do. We got to get Ice Beam, which I'll do off screen. We got to do the Dragon Gen quest. We got to do Route 45 Skarmory quest. We got to do the cave by Route 45. There's about 4 things to do on my list. One's going to be off screen, so 3 are going to be on camera to show for you lovely people. But with the Dragon quest, we're actually going to buy the Dragon Scale off the Pokemon World Online store, because finding it could take a lifetime, and I don't have that patience anymore. So I'll see you guys next time. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please click the like button below, and I'll see you next time. Take care.